As entrepreneurs, you know, we are all so used to being the whole and soul of the company, doing everything. You know, we are the paper pushers, we are the guys with the government, we are the finance people, we will manage the logistics. If some shipment has not gone, we'll jump in and manage the shipment. We are so used to it, to fixing everything and being there for everything, that I think often we don't realize our own inherent weaknesses or what we're not able to do. And I think not getting a super quality team very early in my company was probably my biggest mistake to date. When you're having, you know, more average quality people and you're making all the decisions, that assumes that when you have an average HR head or you have an average marketing head or an average logistics head, that their lack of knowledge will be covered up by your knowledge. But we're not experts on everything. And frankly, today when I have good CHROs and good CMOs and good CFOs, I mean, often I sit with them and I think, damn, I didn't know that at all, right? I really didn't know that. And I'm learning so much that I actually just didn't know. And actually, it was my bad decision-making that landed up with us many times in trouble because I didn't know better, because I wasn't an expert on the subject. The one thing if I could do differently would be to hire and build that really high-quality team very early on, which would have allowed the organization to grow much further by today. The same way I think with organizations, our role as entrepreneurs need to keep changing. I think when we're small companies, at least for me, when mine was a very small company, 50, 60, 70, 80 people, you know, few centers, I needed to be the heart and soul. I needed to be everything for the organization. I needed to be physically present, emotionally present, mentally present, in every way for everything. That was very, very important for me to have a real pulse of who my child is, what it's going to grow up to be, you know, what the future is going to look. But as it became a medium-sized organization, I think the only evolution possible was for it not to be only influenced by the mother, but to be let it be influenced by the grandfather and the father and the chacha and the mama and the kaka, basically allow other professionals or other people in the organization to influence it, so it can grab from me and from them the best things possible. Because otherwise, my kid, my Metropolis, was going to land up being a mirror reflection of me, right? Because it was going to have all my strengths and all my weaknesses. And while, sure, I'm happy it has my strengths, I don't want it to have my weaknesses. I want it to have strengths from other people as well. And I think giving it that space as a medium-sized organization to step back a little bit and allow other people to influence it, even though you may sometimes not necessarily agree, at least to me, was a very crucial part of letting Metropolis evolve to being its own independent being, rather than this being a copycat or a mirror image of me.